that's that I have a strange mystery. I sailed the way to China in a little rough boat to find you, and you said you had to get your laundry clean.
What's up, Chew Tube? It's me again. I'm back, and I'm still fat. How about that? Hey, I just made a little rhyme there. Anyways, how are y'all doing today? I'm doing pretty good myself. I just thought I'd come here this Monday afternoon and give you a little update on what's been going on. This past weekend, I kind of had some unexpected celebratory events and ended up falling off the wagon a little bit and had a couple of meals that I probably shouldn't have. Actually, I shouldn't have. There's no probably to it. But as with anything, nobody's perfect. I'm by no means perfect. And with that being said, I was punished severely for it. When doing this, you're changing something in your gut. And when you've had carbs out of your system, and when I had it, I was about 5 days, 6 days without carbs. And I had that meal, and my body let me know. Whoo, boy, I hurt. I'm still kind of feeling like crud from it, just kind of wore out. And your GI tract does not take too kindly to you adding carbs back like that, especially after a week of fasting and no carbs at all. But needless to say, that's out of the way. We're gonna go forward with, say, our lesson is learned. We ain't gonna try to experience no more of that bathroom time or upset stomach and just mental and physical. Ugh. I never realized how much food could really affect your mental health, your thought process, just your emotional and physical well-being. It's amazing. Because of it, I probably didn't get as good a result as I would have, but even with that little slide, I weighed in today at 216 even. My belly, I did all my tape measurements, and my belly, I actually lost a half an inch around my belly. I'm at 46 and a half inches on my belly. My chest, I lost a quarter of an inch. So I'm at 45 and a half there, and I lost a quarter of an inch around my neck, and I'm right at 17 even on that. So, I mean, though I suffered the consequences for a little bit of mouth pleasure, it ended up being a lot of pain on the backside. So we're with that in mind going forward. I'm going to, continue to log meals, I'm feeling pretty good right now, so I think I'm just going to go ahead and do a 48-hour fast. I haven't eaten today, I'm not hungry at all. I think I'm just going to keep on with the snake juice. If you don't know what snake juice is, go check out Cole Robinson, one of the other snowflakes. Ye be warned, he's very brash, cuts through the BS and loud, and he'll motivate you if you've got some intestinal fortitude. But his snake juice, basically, it's a salt water mix. He's got a couple different recipes. I'm not going to go into all the details on it, but it helps get your sodium levels up, keeps your electrolytes up, keeps you hydrated, and makes fasting a bit easier because it curbs the carb hunger, the carb addictions, and the hunger pains. It's helped me. Might go check it out. I wouldn't advise doing it until you've talked to your doctor. I am by no means a medical professional or a nutritionist of any kind. This is just my little journey for my little experiment to see how things go and just kind of log everything so people out there thinking about doing this can see firsthand the results and kind of tell you what's going on, ups and downs, and all that good stuff. If there's anything, any kind of questions y'all have, any ideas, comments, concerns, leave them down in the comment section. If you're interested to keep tracking, keep following along with my little journey here, Hit that like button. Let me know. I'll keep putting videos on here. Subscribe, hit that notification bell, and you'll get notified every time I come on. Hopefully, before too long, I'll be able to put some better quality video out. I'm gonna start trying to record more daily stuff. Life, you know how it is, it gets busy. I'm gonna try to dedicate more time to this and get do more editing and try to capture more of my day to day, so you have a more in-depth view of everything that I do and the way I feel throughout the day, and see if it's something that you'd be interested in doing. But that being said, I'm gonna get off here. I think I'm gonna go for a walk around the block and just kind of enjoy the rest of the afternoon, rest of the Labor Day weekend. I hope y'all are having a great and safe Labor Day weekend, and we'll see you around the dinner table.